This video will be about Berlin. If you are more interested in certain attractions, you can actually look in the description box, whereby you can just skip to whichever attractions you are more interested in. First thing I'm going to talk about is the Museum of Technology. Entry fee was actually quite cheap, below 10 euros. It's even cheaper if you're a student. It featured lots of cars throughout the years. And if you love cars, you really have to be here. You have the Porsches, the BMs, and also other kind of cool stuff. This is a weighing machine where you just step on it. Telephones and computers, basically a lot of technology related stuff. And this is a library that has many German books, but I don't understand German, so I didn't really manage to read any of the books. Still quite a nice place. So they have exhibits like this, whereby you have a telephone over there, and through its own mechanism, right inside the museum, actually right beside the telephone, you can make a phone call to any telephone, which you can see here. So she made a phone call to me and I managed to pick up. So that is the mechanism you can see on the right. And on the other side of the museum, you have many of these like fun exhibits. This is a mirror which distorts the image of you. And there are many of such mirrors and such exhibits, which was pretty cool actually. So there are about 4 floors of this other side of the museum. This is the first floor, whereby you have many kinds of mirrors, optical illusions. Here you can see that your body elongates, but your legs are very short. So this is a perfect place for children to go to, or if you are just interested in these kinds of things. There's a floor for sound related exhibits. So this one plays music, which varies according to the position of the cubes. And there are also exhibits relating to air movement, such as this. So basically, a column of air is actually blowing out at the ball. And here we try to throw the ball onto the device. Oh, missed. Onto the device so that, you know, the ball will continue floating on top. Yeah, something like this, I guess. And you have other cool exhibits like this, which is the creation of a water spout. This is what their metro looks like in Germany. And there are many of these Holocaust related museums, whereby you can find out about how the Jews lived during that time period. You can find out about their stories. Here are some artifacts. And you can find out about how they felt during that period. Here we have the Holocaust Tower. Basically a very small and dark room, but it's a very tall room with a tiny light at the top. This is a place for you to really reflect on the Holocaust. The Garden of Exile. There are also many similar structures like this, which you can see later in the video. There are also many kinds of exhibits in the museum, relating not just to the Holocaust, but also to how the Jews lived, their way of life, and their stories. So these are some portraits. And next we went to Checkpoint Charlie. So this is a place where you can take a picture with the American soldier, but apparently it's a paid service. So when we were there, we actually experienced a situation whereby some people refused to pay for the service, and they had an argument with the actor dressing up as an American soldier over there. So that was not a very good experience. Hopefully when you're there, you will not experience the same thing. So this is an exhibit. This is the free portion of the exhibit. There's a paid version as well. We did not go to the paid version, but I guess it would be quite interesting. And to be honest, it's not too expensive. So one thing about Berlin is that there's a very wide variety of food available. It's a very international city. So one of the restaurants we went to was this restaurant called ASIN Restaurant, which sold Singapore and Southeast Asian food. And there are many cafes as well. And this is one of the major attractions. This is the garden beside the Berlin Cathedral. And this is a Berlin Cathedral, as you can see here. The Berlin Cathedral was one of the most massive cathedrals I visited in Europe. Maybe it's because it's the first cathedral that I visited, so I might have some bias. But it was really majestic. The whole architecture of it. And the scale is just jaw-dropping. Like, you just step into this, into the main hall, and it is so huge. Like, this video doesn't even do it justice. Yeah, you have to go there. The entry fee is, I think it was 5 euros for students, maybe a bit more for adults. And if you top up a bit more, you can get an audio guide available in English and many other international languages. So the architecture of this had a lot of significance. You can find out about it at the information booths around the cathedral. And you can see the light shining in the cathedral, really lights up. And it gives you a sense of like enlightenment or a sense of hope. So there are many tombs as well. And many of such rooms and exhibits for you to visit. This is the silent room. And there are exhibits on the way up. So basically you start at the ground floor and then you make your way up slowly to the rooftop. Presumably if you want to go to the rooftop to enjoy the view. So there are many of such exhibits on the way up. And I must caution you that the staircase climb from the ground floor to the top was actually quite tiring. So if maybe you have some injuries, you might not be able to make the climb, but it should be okay for most people. So this is the last stretch of the climb, whereby I was extremely tired at this point, but the view was quite amazing, to say the least. You can see here a 360 view of Berlin, which of course you have to walk around the structure to see the view at every point. So this is the canal, it's quite a large canal, just right beside the Berlin Cathedral. And right beside that is this, the German Historical Museum. But we did not visit the museum, but you can choose to. There are many different kinds of architecture in Berlin as well. And the food here is just amazing. You must try their pork knuckle and the beer. Pork knuckle, if I'm not wrong, it was about 20 euros. And we also visited the memorial to the murdered Jews of Europe. Please do me a favor, if you come here, please do not smile and laugh. And please do not take like selfies in a very disrespectful manner. Some videos and pictures I think is okay. But please do not step. Go to the extent of stepping on the stones. And this is the Brandenburg Gate. very popular tourist spot. The gate is quite majestic, but the sun was just, it was facing us, so we could not really take a nice photo, unfortunately. This is the Reichstag Building, whereby the parliament convenes. You have to make a booking to enter the Reichstag Building in much in advance, so please make sure you make the booking. So this is the Berlin Wall, they call it the East Side Gallery. So there's many different kinds of artworks. You might have heard of the popular one where two politicians kissed. It's available there as well. And there are many scammers trying to scam you of your money. They do this by playing a game with you, and they will definitely take your money because it's not a game of chance, because they have planned it to make it go against you. So please do not fall for the trap. And this is the night market. There's quite a wide variety of food and drinks available. There's seafood, oysters, juices, different kinds of wine. This place was quite crowded, and I felt that it was like a tourist trap to me. You know, quantity of food was very small and quite expensive actually. So I'll end off with some more footage of the nice cars you can see in the museum. If you are a car fanatic, you'll definitely go crazy here.